dat de UK voor de lezing committee over de common to conference in our university. I want to open our meeting for today. The first words I want to ask first the vice rector of scientific efforts of our university, the Van Franco National University of Greece, Professor Roman Podleshevsky. Yes.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, dear participants of the 25th International Scientific Conference on Current Problems in Applied Mathematics and Informatics, and the 34th International Conference on Problems of Decision-Making Under Uncertainty. In the name of the Rectorate, I would like to welcome you to the Ivan Franko National University of Lviv. The history of the University of Lviv goes back to 1661, when the King of Poland, Jan Kazimierz II, signed an official paper granting the right to teach all contemporary university subjects and to deliver academic degrees. The new university consisted of two faculties, theology and philosophy, and counted some 500 students. In 1744, a faculty of mathematics was opened, and the laboratory of mathematics and physics was set up. Through its history, the university has had to adapt to several geopolitical changes. When the city of Lviv passed from Poland to Austria, back to Poland, to the USSR and Ukraine. Depending on the ruling government, the official languages were Polish, German or Ukrainian. In 1919, the school received the official name Jan Kazimierz University in honor of its founder, but it's in 1940 it was renamed to Ivan Franko Lviv State University after the Ukrainian poet, writer, statesman Ivan Franko, who studied at the Faculty of Philosophy in the 1870s. In 1999, it was conferred the status national by the Ukrainian authorities. In 2019, the Ivan Franko National University of Lviv is one of the leading higher education institutions of Ukraine. It consists of 19 faculties, subdivided into 140 departments, an institute of advanced studies, 3 colleges, 9 research institutes, an observatory, a botanic garden, and a library. The total number of students exceeds 20,000, and the academic staff is composed of more than 2,000 lecturers, including 2/3 of postdoc assistants and professors. The city of Lviv has many names. You may have heard of it as Lvov, or as Lemberg, or even Leopolis, the city of the lion. The town was named after Leo, the eldest son of King Danilo of Galicia. Today, with more than 750,000 inhabitants, Lviv is the center of Western Ukraine and the 7th largest city in Ukraine. The city is an important cultural center and has several institutions of higher education, such as the Ivan Franko National University of Lviv, where we are now, Lviv Polytechnic National University and Lviv National Medical University. The historic city center is on the UNESCO World Heritage List. The city of Lviv is also known thanks to the Lvov School of Mathematics, which existed between the two world wars. Among these mathematicians were Hugo Steinhaus, Stefan Banach, Stanislav Mazur, Stanislav Ulam, who became famous also as the authors of the so-called Scottish Book. The first electronic computer in Western Ukraine, named Ural 1, was installed at the Ivan Franko State University in 1958. The installation of more and more computers created an urgent need for specialists to ensure the functioning of the machines, and the Department of Computational Mathematics, one of the first of its kind in USSR, was founded at the University of Lviv by Oleksandr Kostovsky in 1975. Since that time, there has been an intense research activity both on fundamental and applied computer science at the university, accompanying the progress in electronic instrumentation and engineering. The dean of the faculty will give you more information, but only a few words about the faculty. Today, the Faculty of Applied Mathematics and Informatics employs some 20 ordinary and 40 associate professors. It is subdivided into 7 departments with research activities in the fields of computer modeling of processes and systems, development of modern information systems, numerical methods for solving operator equations, methods for solving optimization problems, artificial intelligence systems, creation of computer software for education, and many others. Nobody questions the importance of applied mathematics and informatics in the world of today, and it will still increase. Lviv occupies a special place in the field within Ukraine, since in total some 4,500 IT students graduate from Lviv universities every year, and the city counts more than 300 IT companies. Dear participants of the joint conference, I wish you a successful meeting with interesting presentations and scientific discussions. As a chemist, I have with pleasure seen that some of the titles treat fields of chemistry, such as Schrödinger equations, hydrocarbons. There exist numerous possibilities to apply computational science in chemistry and material science, and that is only a small part of the immense field of possible applications. I hope that the conference will offer you an opportunity to discover common and complementary scientific interests and develop new ideas and collaborations. For those of you who are not from Lviv, I hope that you will find also time to visit our beautiful town and enjoy its particular atmosphere. Thank you.
I want to ask, I think it is the first time in the history of Ukraine that the president held second speech, the first speech in our conference. I want to ask the chairman of International Program Committee, the founder of the PDMU conference, the president of the Academy of Science of High School, Professor Oleksandr Matvievich, please.
Together with conference of applied mathematics. opportunity to hold a conference in one of the oldest universities of Ukraine, where I worked and work feminist science. I hope that this conference will be successful. I have a honor mission. Academy Ukraine, high school in Ukraine, have ever for academica, our academy, Professor Saul. This is ever is medal laureate. Yaroslav Modrikov, Demi, this medal, this is from. We have medal Academy 20-year Academy.
They have provided as host and
to the conference organizing committee, particularly Professor Senior and Professor Zinko, as co-chairmen who have put together an engaging program. It is a great pleasure for me to declare open the common conferences. Say welcome to participants from many countries of Europe and presence here some persons, allow me to say, of the world, who came here to exchange experience and work together a few days on exciting fields of informatics and applied mathematics and maybe make some decision on the dangers. I know you are all very busy and it's difficult to make time away from you daily tasks for me. I appreciate you for your arrival to me. A few words about our faculty, which was founded in 1975. Currently, there are 5 specialists in our faculty under bachelor's and master's programs. More than 1,100 people are studying now. In recent years, the number of students in our department has almost doubled, mainly due to the new submission rules and significant growth of amount of IT companies in the region. There are more than 350 IT companies in our city today. Before coming to the close of these remarks, I would also like to remind you that the central part of Lviv is included to heritage of UNESCO. I wish you good weather because what you see outside, that is all we have to provide you with our limited resources. One of the hard problems of organizing committee was financing and of the event. I want to thank our sponsors, software and technical company, IT companies of Lviv. I sincerely hope that you will enjoy today and next 2 days of debate and networking. Thank you very much for your participation and thank you for your attention.
Maybe someone wants to say some words. Let us begin the first plenary session of our conference. 5 minutes, if you will, we will prepare presentation, first section. The numerical solution of non-stationary problems of elasticity. I will say about 2 problems which have variables, time variables. The first problem was the quasi-static thermal elasticity problem in which we will consider non-stationary heat conduction problems, and another one, it will be 3 dynamic theory of elasticity of anisotropic axisymmetric objects. First time we will consider quasi static thermoelasticity problem. It's usual when we consider problems which have time variables. In time variables, we discretize the problems, used finite difference method and finite element method, or we consider Laplace transforming in time variable. We proposed in this presentation two another discretization. In first problem, when we fundamental solution of non-stationary parabolic equation for the problem of thermal conductivity. The problem of thermal elasticity.